Hello, my name is Sean, also known as Chilli Chump, and welcome to my channel. In my recent video, 10 Facts About Chilies, I asked if you wanted a dedicated video on the health benefits. A lot of you said yes, so here you go. I have listed citations for all the research I've done down below in the description, and there will be an article on my website in the future as well. Chilies are packed with vitamins and minerals. Ripe chilies are one of the richest sources of vitamin C. In fact, a red bell pepper has more than double the amount of vitamin C compared to an orange, and it contains more than your daily recommended amount. They also contain vitamin B6, vitamin B9 or folate, vitamin K1, vitamin E, potassium, iron, magnesium, and beta carotene, which your body converts to vitamin A. I did make a mistake in the last video saying that it converts to vitamin D. That's wrong. It is vitamin A. Most interesting, however, is that chilies contain capsaicin. This is the part of the chili that gives it its spice. Capsaicin is most apparent in the placental tissue, the part that holds the seeds. The seeds themselves don't have or produce capsaicin, but the reason people say to remove the seeds when cooking is because the seeds are coated by that placental tissue. The capsaicin receptor is called TRPV1, or the transient receptor potential channel of the vanilloid receptor family, subtype 1. This was only identified fairly recently in 1997. A member of that team that discovered it was David Julius, and he won a Nobel Prize for this work in 2021, so only last year. Most of the medical benefits I will talk about next are related to capsaicin and the TRPV1 receptor. So let's get into it. A study was done where hamsters were put on a high cholesterol diet. They were then divided into two groups, one group getting a supplement of capsaicin in their diet and the control group receiving none. When the results were analyzed, the scientists found some interesting things. Not only were the total cholesterol levels reduced, but the capsaicinoids reduced the levels of bad cholesterol without affecting the levels of good cholesterol. They also found that capsaicin was reducing the deposits that were already in the blood vessels. These deposits are what can contribute to the narrowing of arteries that can result in strokes or heart attacks. It was noticed in countries where people eat larger quantities of chilies every day had lower occurrences of functional gut diseases like IBS. A double-blind controlled study was done on the effects of chili peppers on IBS symptoms. Over the six-week study, it was shown that consuming chilies significantly improved abdominal pain in IBS patients compared to the placebo. Functional dyspepsia, or indigestion with no obvious cause such as ulcers or acid reflux, is hugely common. In 2002, a study was done which found that eating 2.5 grams of spicy red chilies for 5 weeks significantly improved epigastric pain after an initial period of actually worsening it. In another study on patients with non-erosive reflux disease, or NERD, similar results were found. There was initially an increased sensitivity to the pain, but subsequently there was a decrease, quite a significant decrease in the sensitivity and also the symptoms. In tropical countries, chilies are consumed to handle the hot weather by increasing the regulation of heat loss with capsaicin-induced skin vasodilation and perspiration. Back in 1878, researcher André Hoagyes was the first to observe the burning sensation produced by injecting capsaicin. The burning sensation resulted in reflex hyperemia, or increased blood flow, without any sign of inflammation. This also resulted in a considerable decrease in body temperature. Further experiments were done in 1950, where a small amount of capsaicin was injected into a rabbit. This dropped the rabbit's body temperature from 36.6 degrees Celsius to a minimum of 30.5 degrees Celsius within 30 minutes. At this point, the temperature gradually began to rise again to normal levels. The effects were far less pronounced when the rabbit was desensitized to the capsaicin. The first formal report of pain-reducing properties of chili extracts concerned toothache treatment. However, long before this, Native Americans would actually rub their gums with chilies to relieve their toothache. Topical use, or rubbing it on your skin, of capsaicin has been found to be potent in the management of skin disorders, shingles, muscle strain, arthritis-related disorders, diabetic neuropathy, and other pain disorders. It has even been shown to be effective in treating chronic migraines and cluster headaches. In the study that I'll reference down below, the capsaicin was administered nasally. That sounds painful. Repeated doses resulted in desensitization not only to capsaicin, but other stimuli as well. The doses were fairly low, but this still caused a burning sensation, which subsided after about 10 minutes. The control group, which didn't get capsaicin, were given low concentrations of citric acid to emulate the burning sensation. The results of the study showed a significant improvement compared to the placebo. And not so fun fact, eunuchs who served the Chinese emperors would rub their scrotums with hot chili extracts as an analgesic before getting castrated. Ouch. TRPV1 receptors are densely distributed in the urinary tract. It is known that TRPV1 receptors are important in overactive bladder diseases, and modulating the receptors can reduce the symptoms. A study was done in 2007 and it suggested that TRPV1 channels play a role in detection of bladder filling. A common human health issue is sudden involuntary contraction of the bladder muscle, which causes an overactive bladder. And capsaicin has successfully been used to reduce bladder overactivity in many of these subjects. Alzheimer's disease is the most common cause of age-related dementia. Studies suggest that there is a geographic overlap between Alzheimer's incidence and spicy food consumption. A study found that intake of capsaicin reduced brain amyloid beta burden and rescued cognitive decline in APP/PS1 mice. These are mice with mutations associated with early onset Alzheimer's. Amyloid beta, those are the main components of amyloid plaques, which are found in the brains of people with Alzheimer's disease. The study goes on to suggest that capsaicin is a potential therapeutic candidate for Alzheimer's disease and warrants clinical trials on chili peppers or capsaicin as a dietary supplementation for the prevention and treatment of Alzheimer's disease. An earlier study by the same team concluded that a capsaicin-rich diet consumption was associated with better cognition in people aged 40 years and over, so that's fantastic news for me. TRPV1 is present in many metabolically active tissues. This makes it a prime target for studies in obesity, type 2 diabetes, and non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. Capsaicin treatment in mice fed a high-fat diet for 10 weeks lowered obesity, fasting glucose, insulin, leptin, inflammatory markers in adipose tissue, and liver and hepatic triglycerides. This is probably the most fascinating part of the research I did. The studies are ongoing and there are plenty of them. Capsaicin has been reported to decrease cancer cell growth, cell cycle arrest, and trigger programmed cell death in several cancer cell lines, including adenocarcinoma, breast cancer, colon cancer, cutaneous cell carcinoma, esophageal carcinoma, gastric cancer, glioma, hepatocellular carcinoma, leukemia, multiple myeloma, nasopharyngeal carcinoma, non-small cell lung cancer, pancreatic cancer, prostate cancer, tongue cancer, and many others. It is also shown to exhibit anti-cancer activity by decreasing the progression of tumors in mice. Worldwide, gastric cancer is one of the leading causes of death by cancer, and several studies have shown that capsaicin can inhibit the proliferation of gastric cancer cells and promote their apoptosis, or programmed cell death. If you learned anything in this video, please hit that like button down below. It really helps the channel out. With the discovery of the TRPV1 receptor being relatively recent, the amount of research into the effects of capsaicin has significantly increased since 1997. It'll be interesting to see what new discoveries are uncovered in the coming years. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and you found it interesting. And until the next one, stay spicy.